I'm very much looking forward to the My Face, My Body Awards. It's an honour to be here. Obviously, the cosmetics industry is a multi-billion dollar industry. I'm personally not pressured to change anything about myself because I believe this is the way that God made me. And I think you need to look for why you're feeling so insecure, why you're feeling so sad, why you think that an enhancement will please someone. Because I think it's so much deeper than that, and every act of kindness is important. There's a special pressure on women to look a certain way, and it doesn't go unnoticed, unfortunately. And I don't understand why we're so judgmental and so critical, because our DNA is 99.9% the same. And I believe that you could take a very, very ordinary person and make them look spectacular in Photoshop. It's just a matter of applying the right tools to the subject. And I think we really have to analyse the bigger issues, like natural disasters and self-harm and eating disorders and, you know, I think that everyone's been bullied at some point in their life, everyone. And you've got to wonder why people feel this need to attack other people. And it's usually because they feel discomfort within themselves. So just be you, be true, and be the one you need. And my role models are everyone in the universe that dares to be different. And all my role models are effectively dead. They're people that have shaped history, like Florence Nightingale and Chaucer and William Shakespeare, most notably. Because without William Shakespeare, we wouldn't be having this conversation currently. He is the backbone of all modern English literature. The Queen, of course. It's wonderful.
What's coming up next for you post-show?
I'm currently being kept very busy with my agency, and I'm dashing here, there and everywhere, and it's wonderful. The X Factor was such an amazing experience for me. I'm so grateful for the people I've encountered there. In fact, Stephanie Nala, Blonde Lecture, and Charlie Brown are here this evening, and, you know, I can't imagine life without them now. But I believe it was a few months of my life that I had to go through to get to this place, and everything you do is important, and it sets you up for the next horizon. The low was facing terrible nerves, thinking I'm going to let millions of people down every week, literally shaking with nerves and crying before every performance, including my first audition. I had to be shoved into there. And I believe that television can be very deceptive. I think that all of us went through something very hard and very tough, and I'm so proud of everyone who's still in that competition. I personally didn't see it as a competition, I saw it as a vocal showcase, and I refuse to see anything as competitive, because I think that it destroys art. And the highs were just meeting so many amazing people, and I really mean that, I mean, they're here tonight, and it's lovely, because if someone's been through the same experience as you, they can appreciate what you've endured, and it brings you a lot closer together. It's a hard thing, the X Factor. It's no picnic. I'd just like to say thank you so much. If I do inspire you to be yourself, please continue. But the biggest family that you need is yourself. You need to believe in yourself.